Hi, Kelly Eckold here to update you with the key events of the week. So next week we're going to be releasing our new economic forecasts that try to take account of this new global uncertainty that's erupted in the last few months. In many respects, the data in the last few months has really just panned out pretty close to expectations, where we were seeing a gradual economic recovery take hold, and as a result, interest rates have been pretty close to the bottom of the cycle. But we do have those new downside risks now, and we've looked to try to quantify those with an alternative scenario that considers the implications of a sharper downturn in global growth, and as a result, a delayed economic recovery, higher unemployment rate, and weaker terms of trade. That scenario would imply that interest rates have a wee way to go down yet. So as a result, we've adjusted our interest rate track to reflect one more 25 basis point cut in the OCR in July and August, or August, to 3%. In terms of the actual data that we received last week, it was pretty decent. We did get a very strong dairy auction in the middle of the week, and dairy prices went up nearly 5%, which is quite good news for farmers. And also we got the labour market report that showed that the unemployment rate didn't rise from 5.1%, which is pretty good news, and it raises questions about just how high the unemployment rate really is going to peak in this cycle. So overall, the economy looks okay. We don't really see any negative impact on our terms of trade coming from the global outlook right now. The labour market looks like it's performing certainly no worse than expectations. That outlook, it's still very much in pencil. I may need to get my rubber out to adjust things as time goes on. We'll see what happens. So I'll be back to update you again next week, and please consider donating to our chopper appeal, which is out there this month. Thank you very much.